The way to win is as old as time. Do the right thing and put in the fucking work. There's just nothing else. By the way, there's nothing else in anything. How do I become a professional hockey player? Talent and effort. How do I become a tremendous top 1% lawyer? Talent and effort. How do I become a phenomenal mother? Talent and effort. It's talent and effort. And what I love about effort and why I love hustle, and now that it's become so cliche, you see me saying the word work a little bit more now because I just want people to get it. It's controllable. You know how many people here want to be a millionaire? Do you know how rare that is? Have you run the math? You have this enormous audacity, yet you're not putting in the work to get you there because you think somehow you've been tricked by yourself or somebody else that there's some system. Like, really, we're at a place now where kids think it's cool if somebody goes and takes money out of a bank and puts it on their fucking bed and takes a picture of it? Like, what the fuck is the matter with you? You know what really sucks? It sucks when you buy a $20,000 Rolex and the world collapses and you have no money and your Rolex is worth $4,000. That sucks. That's why I always say I'm a tortoise in a hare's costume. You know zero people that have built something big that haven't put in a ridiculous amount of work. And the bigger it is, the more they've worked. So I think you have to execute against your truth. People can smell things. So many of you have your mouth way ahead of your actions. Really? You're gonna own an island and you fucking go to Coachella? Fuck you. When it comes from a truth place, you win. And when it doesn't, you don't. Like, I wasn't born 6'7" and can run like a cheetah. I could wish I was something, or I can realize I am something and try to maximize on that. It's a game of poker. You get a hand. Nobody's gonna cry for you about your hand. Nobody's gonna say, oh, it's terrible that you're not fast or tall or gorgeous or can sing. It is what it is. And now the only thing that can happen is you can figure out how to navigate it. The second you stop dwelling and the second you start doing, everything changes. They don't give a fuck. The second you understand that and just start trying to make shit happen with that energy, you win. Nobody cares about my problems. Nobody has ever cared about my problems. My problems seem far less silly now. I got problems. I don't want to be here on a Saturday when my family's not here. I got problems. But guess what? I made my bed, I'm making my choices, I got my reality. Right. Every single person here has shit. Right. All of you. You all have shit. Do the white dudes have it better? Yes. Guess what? They still have shit. Everybody's got shit. And nobody cares about your shit, they care about their shit because everybody's got shit. So nobody cares about your fucking complaining. Go fucking do something and that's it. Like what? You think somebody's gonna come along and be like, oh, we're so sorry. They don't care.
I'm here for a reason.
You yes. Got it. That's it. All right. Just real quick, where is it? By not worrying about what other people think, it allows you to do things. By doing things, you either win or you learn from your loss, and it creates speed. It's the absolute mental difference between the people that are executing and winning versus the people that aren't. It's the fear of others. I don't want to lose, but I'm definitely more disappointed than your opinion and your blog post about my loss.